¿Cuánto tiempo tiene usted viviendo aquí, señor?
Bueno, en la actualidad tengo como 7 años aquí, en esta área, aquí, pero yo vivía en el otro Batey que desbarataron.
Ajá. ¿Cómo se llama ese Batey que desbarataron?
Construcción.
Construcción. O sea que de todo, por todo el tiempo que usted tiene aquí, tiene más de 20 años aquí. ¿Y cuántas personas viven aquí?
Bueno, hay muchas personas que viven aquí.
¿Cómo cuánto aproximadamente?
Como 80, una cosa así.
Como 80 personas. O sea, pero en familia vienen siendo como 20 familias.
Es más.
Más de 20 familias.
So he was saying that he, in this specific community, he's worked like 7 years. In the area, he's worked 22. And Maximo was asking how many families live here. About more than 20 families live here, and a total of about 80 or so people is this guy's estimate. These houses are the Batey itself is run by the government or owned by the government officially. That's where the housing comes from. And that's, I think, not as common to have the Batey owned by the government, but that's, it possibly was previously a private, run by a private company. The history of the sugarcane communities is very, very difficult because no matter how you turn it, it's one of the most brutal types of work you can do in this country. It's completely physical. There's no machines involved really. It's hands, machete, using a machete and your hands cutting down the sugarcane from morning until evening. So it's incredibly physical and does not pay well at all.
And how many people from this community are receiving a loan through Hope and Esperanza? I know there are some right now inside the building at the community bank meeting. How many are being served?
There's 10 individuals right now receiving loans. And if there's 80 people in this community, that's a pretty sizable chunk since it's such a small community. If they are successful in repaying their loans over a couple loan cycles, then we'll offer them another loan, and we'll also encourage them to add a new group of 5 to their village bank. It sometimes can be difficult in a Batey after a certain point to have many, many, many people, you know, more than 25 or 35 running successful businesses that can repay, because as you can see, the liquidity in communities like this is hard to come by. And because everyone's income is seasonal, you get a lot of seasonal ups and downs that follow the sugarcane. The income that people get is not only low, but it only comes in kind of 6-month cycles. So you get bursts of economic activity and then low seasons. And you're also kind of in the middle of nowhere, so you don't have access to many other resources. The best businesses generally are the ones that connect to other communities where people are able to leave the Batey and maybe sell products at another Batey, or perhaps raise farm animals and kind of build assets that way. But it's the hardest place to run a business.